69-year-old man has died while waiting 4 hours for an ambulance in Melbourne's east.
It's a tragic development in Victoria's ambulance crisis as exhausted paramedics are stretched beyond their limits, left 50 crews short.
6 past 6 this morning, a patient transfer vehicle arrives more than 4 hours after Surry Hills residents called for an ambulance for an emergency situation that turned deadly.
A 4 hour wait for someone who's critically unwell is just unacceptable, and it's shocking, and this is just a tragic outcome, and you can never predict exactly what might have happened if we got to the patient sooner.
At least two neighbours called 000 for help. One could see an elderly man inside his home in pain but couldn't get in and couldn't get a response from the 69-year-old. Neither could ambulance attendants when they finally arrived, calling on firefighters to break into the Windsor Crescent home. The man was already dead.
It was potentially a fall to begin with, but a 4 hour delay really just doesn't give someone who's critically unwell a chance at surviving.
Neighbours were told crews would arrive within the hour. The ambulance union says help should have been there within 30 minutes. Neither were right.
50 drop shifts across the state, that just leaves huge black holes in resourcing. We're hearing of crews travelling from Cranbourne to the CBD as the nearest vehicle. We're hearing of police getting behind the wheel of ambulances to drive single responders to hospitals.
At one point early this morning, just 1% of the state's entire fleet was available.
And I think one of the questions that needs to be asked is why they didn't escalate to code orange or to code red under the state health emergency response plan.
Ambulance Victoria is reviewing the case. Sarah Jane Bell, 7 News.